Now, we have been discussing Acts chapter 1, verse 8.
Kakati tubadde tulina ekyawandiikibwa mu bikolwa by'abatume essuula esooka olunyiriri lwa munaana.
And I will show again how to use that method, God's nature preaching method.
Mbadde njagala kubayitiramu ku mbala ya Katonda, ku nkola ey'embala ya Katonda nga tuyigiriza.
I'm not saying that's the only way to preach.
Wano sibagamba nti y'enkola yokka ey'okubuulira enjiri.
But it's helpful and it helps us to prepare the sermon fast and also how to apply to the needs of the people.
Naye kituyamba okutegeera n'engeri ki gye tusobola okuyigiriza abantu okutegeera obubaka.
Acts 1:8, you can turn to the Bible.
Ebikolwa by'abatume essuula emu olunyiriri lwa munaana.
But you receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you'll be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the world, of the earth.
Ayatuse kwasomi mu Uganda. Na Bible y'Oluganda. Musomi omulungi ow'Oluganda. Nyumirire otusomere.
Okay.
Tewali anaba kutuuka. Agambye bw'ati. Bikola abatume essuula esooka olunyiriri lwa munaana. Naye muliwe bw'amaanyi, Omwoyo Omutukuvu bw'alimala okujja mu mmwe, nammwe munaabanga bajulirwa abange mu Yerusaalemi ne mu Buyudaaya bonna ne mu Samaliya n'okutuusa ku nkomero y'ensi.
Okay. Now, for the introduction,
wano enyanjula,
I want to raise the people's interest in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Kubanga enyanjula tuba twagala okuyimusa ekyetaago ky'abantu ku bubaka bwe tugenda okubawa.
Now for myself, I can describe how I was before I was filled with the Holy Spirit and afterwards.
Nga nze nsobola okweyogerako ngamba mbeera ki gye nalimu nga sinafuna amaanyi g'omutukuvu na mbeera ki gye nabeeramu ng'amaze okufuna amaanyi g'omutukuvu.
Before I was filled with the Holy Spirit, I noticed that I did not take care of my sins as completely as after I experienced the Holy Spirit.
Nga sinafuna omwoyo mutukuvu nalinewuranga nesala musango nga ndi wansi w'ekibi nga kifuga mu bulamu bwange naye bwe namala okufuna amaanyi g'omutukuvu.
I allow many sinful thoughts and actions stay in my life.
Nali nga mpulire ng'ekibi nga kifugira mu bulamu bwange.
And also, my relationship with God is not so intimate.
Nari mpulira n'enkolagana yange ne Katonda nga tetuukiridde.
And also, my ministry is not as powerful.
Nari mpulira n'obuweereza bwange nga si bw'amaanyi.
I was not able to raise up anyone to serve God.
Nari nga sisobola kuyimusa abantu mu kuweereza Mukama.
And actually, for a number of times I said, Lord, please come back soon so I don't have to serve you anymore on earth. I want to go to heaven.
Nani mpulira nga ntuuse n'ekiseera ekigamba Mukama sikyasobola kukuweereza mpozi kati neegendere ngende mu ggulu.
In heaven I don't have to serve God anymore.
Kubanga nani mpulira nga sikyasobola kuweereza Mukama.
Now, but after I experienced the Holy Spirit,
naye bwe nawulira nafuna amaanyi g'omutukuvu,
when the evangelist lay hand on me,
omubuulizi w'enjiri bwe yanteekako emikono,
I experienced power like electricity enter me.
Nawulira amaanyi nga gali ng'amasanyalaze nga gaka ku bulamu bwange.
I experienced a great love entering me.
Nawulira okwagala kungi nga kunzijjudde.
So powerfully, I cried for a long time.
Nawulira amaanyi ne ntandika okukaaba akaseera kawanvu.
And after that, my relationship with God was much, much deeper.
Nawulira enkolagana ne Katonda nga yeeyongedde egendedde ddala buziba.
I enjoy God anytime.
Nawulira nga neeyongedde okwagala Mukama.
I like God all the time.
Nawulira nga neeyongedde ngenze wala mu kwagala Mukama.
And I pray to God many times a day.
Nagendera mu maaso okusaba nga nsaba ekaseera kawamu mu lunaku. Esaala nyingi mu lunaku.
And also God let me see my sins much more.
Nasaddamu okuwulira ng'ebibi byange nga neesalira omusango munze.
And God helped me to handle many of my sins.
Nawulira nga Mukama ajjiddeko ddala ebibi byange byonna.
And I pursue a complete holiness in God.
Natandika okugoberera obutuukirivu bwa Mukama.
Now I'm not perfect.
Nali nga siri mutuukirivu.
But any moment I have any sinful thought, I'll take care of it by the help of God, anytime.
Nchimanyi siri mutukirivu na hivu kasera kwa nanga mpulide chitari kia mutukirivu nina okubanga nina chenchi kwa lakonga nene nyamasu ga mukama.
And God also told me many ideas how to teach people.
Mukama yampe ngeni nyingi jensoboro kukonsa nganjigiri za bantu.
And in my heart also I have zeal for the Lord.
Mutima kwa nge na uri nanga ntandi sokuri ne njala ne nyota nga mjagaro kuweleza mukama.
I really want to serve God.
Na uri nanga njagari dedaro kuweleza.
I want to bless more people.
Na uri nanga njagaro kuwa bantu omukisa.
I put down myself. And put God as the purpose of my life. So here is an introduction. And then the first point here is how many Christians don't have the power of God, of the Holy Spirit. Many Christians or even pastors would find it difficult to serve God. They find it difficult to have ideas of sermons. They find it difficult to have messages that can change people's life. They find it difficult to change people's spiritual life. And many churches remain very weak. And the people commit adultery, have all kinds of sins and fights against each other. And it doesn't glorify God. And very hard for the church to grow. And many Christians say, I don't have the motivation to pray. Now, after experience the Holy Spirit, I think of prayer as enjoying God. I can pray for a long time. So I just say, oh Lord, you're loving me. I love you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh Jesus.
Yes.
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I can pray for long hours. I can enjoy the peace and the love and the joy of the Lord. And I can serve God for a long time. So first I talk about the weaknesses of many Christians. Also here you can talk about the positive testimonies of some Christians. How after they experience the Holy Spirit, the whole life is changed. And then the second point, God's nature. God is full of power. We can see God's power in nature. We can see the power of lightning. We can see the power of the sun to give life. God is almighty. And also many people's lives are changed by God. Many lazy Christians experience the Holy Spirit. They experience the love of God, the joy of the Lord, the freedom of the Lord. And suddenly they start to love the Lord. I have known some Christians, they were changed by one meeting when they experienced the Holy Spirit. So in God there is abundance of power. And whenever that power touches someone,
amanyi bwe kwata ku muntu.
And if that person responds to God,
omuntu oyo nakiriza Katonda,
his whole life is changed.
Obulamu bwe bwonna bukyuka.
Now pay attention to how I describe it. I don't just say God is powerful, I describe it.
Njagala mukitegeera ddala abasumba muwulire nga bwe nkyogeddeko ensonga eno mugikwatire ddala.
Like myself, I have this motivation to continue to love God.
Ekyokulabirako nganza ng'omuntu mpulira nga nina eki nzibwamu amaanyi okuweereza Mukama.
I have the motivation to pray to God.
Nina amaanyi okusaba.
I have the motivation to go to different difficult countries to train people. So he is powerful to motivate me. And also I have trained a number of Christians and then they were motivated to serve God. And on the internet, you can watch many videos of people changed by God. There are many people of different religions, and then they ask God, who are you? And then they saw Jesus in a dream. And the whole life is changed. And then they start to believe in Jesus. Or some lazy Christians. Or very weak Christian. And then they experience the Holy Spirit. And then they are changed by God. So we can see God can change people instantly. Okay, now, and then the next point, why are people, you know, are not changed by the power of the Holy Spirit? Why are so many Christians not changed? So what is the difficulty? Now, one big reason is because people think of God as very far away.
Ensonga enkulu ereetera abantu obutakyuka abamu balowooza nti Katonda alieyo wala.
They don't believe that God's power can come to them like that.
Tebakkiriza nti n'amaanyi ga Katonda gasobola okubasembera okubatuukako.
And also many people have distance with God.
Abantu abamu bali wala ne Katonda.
Also when many people pray, they just pray with their mind, with their mouth.
Abantu abamu ne bwe basaba basaba olw'ebigambo ku mimwa abantu babawulire.
So they don't experience the Holy Spirit much.
Abo tebafaayo na mu bya mwoyo mutukuvu by'omwoyo wa Mukama.
Now I have known some Christians in traditional church that don't accept the power of the Holy Spirit. I have known some Christians like that.
Traditional churches.
But they kept praying to God. And they felt the power of God. They felt the power, they felt shaking under the power of God. They experienced the peace and the motivation of the Holy Spirit. And they want to love God more. So no matter what background, if people believe that God is almighty and is loving, and they spend long time praying, and pray with the Spirit, they can experience the Holy Spirit. Now, but there are many Christians like this. Look at me. Look at me, everyone. They pray like this. Jesus, help me. I'm sick. I'm weak. Come to help me. Oh, when they're praying, they just look around. When we pray like this, the heart is not open.
But
when we see that God is so beautiful and powerful,
and
open our heart to love God, our whole life will be changed. So, now also in many churches, they don't believe in miracles, they don't believe in the infilling of the Holy Spirit. They speak worse against the Holy Spirit. But we tell these people, we pray in Jesus' name. We ask God to forgive us. We love Jesus' salvation. We love God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And we want to follow God. Everything we do is according to the Bible. Just when we pray more, we have the power of God. And then when we pray for people, we pray in Jesus' name. And they love God more. That is the fruit of the Holy Spirit. But many of these Christians still don't accept it. They say, we have never been like that. And they think the way they pray in the church, oh God heal me, God bless me, that's the only way to pray. And what happened is they're not willing to change. And they do not allow the Holy Spirit to change your life. But if they change, then they can be filled with the Holy Spirit. Okay, and then how can we be filled with the Holy
Spirit?
First, we say we need the power of the Holy Spirit. We need God to give us power to do evangelism. And then what we do is first we hate sin. We turn away from sins. Now there are many Christians, they go to church but they can go home and they yell at the wife and husband. And even many Christians who commit adultery. And many Christians worry and doubt. So they think it's okay to sin. And that way they cannot be filled with the Holy Spirit. So we want to hate sin. And turn away from sin by the help of God. And then number two, we believe in the Bible. The promises in the Bible. God promises that He loves us very much. He wants to give us the power of the Holy Spirit. And number three, have faith. Believe that God wants to fill us with the Holy Spirit. It's not very difficult. When we love God, we can be filled with the Holy Spirit. And number four, worship in spirit and in truth. The Holy Spirit worship God. And a whole soul worship God. Worship God with our mind, our will, and our feelings. And a whole spirit worship God for a long time. For the whole day, if you are doing other things, keep loving God.
Let
me ask you, do you hunger for the power of the Holy Spirit? If you hunger for the Holy Spirit, you pay the price to pray. And also, in these 2 days, when you experience the Holy Spirit, we go home and keep praying. You keep the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And number five, you hunger for the Holy Spirit. And then number six, we want to obey God and follow the Great Commission to preach the gospel. And number seven, put down all the worries, all the negative feelings. Live in a peaceful, joyful way. And then you can keep the anointing. Do you want to keep the anointing of the Holy Spirit? Do you want to carry the power of God and you pray for people and you see people healed? Now there are many stories that I have that I pray for people and they experience a great change of God. I have many stories. But because of time, I don't know if it's ready for lunch. I'll stop here.
Yes,
is the lunch ready?
Okay.
So, do you want the Holy Spirit? Do you want to live in the love of God? You know, any time I pray, Jesus, the joy will come out. And the power go through my whole person. Hallelujah. And His love comes to me. When you hunger for God and you like God very much, you have a lot of strength and power. You have a lot of joy and peace. And you can serve God with a lot of power. Do you want that? Are you willing to pay the price? Go home and keep that. Go home and keep the presence of God. Hallelujah. Now just now, briefly summarize again the few points, remember? Now the reason I want to talk about the negative so people see the beauty of the positive. Now I just summarize here. Introduction. I talk about how I was before I was filled with the Holy Spirit and how I was after. So you can talk about some people, how they were before they experienced the Holy Spirit, how they are. Yeah, wait for me to finish. How they are after they experienced the Holy Spirit. Okay, and then the first point is, when people don't have the power of the Holy Spirit, they are weak. And they are burdened and they have sins and they don't know how to handle. And ministry is difficult. So that's the difficulty without the Holy Spirit, without the infilling of the Holy Spirit. And then God's nature, His power, His ability to change people. And then number three, why So many people cannot be filled with the Holy Spirit. What are the hindrances? And then for how we can be filled with the Holy Spirit. Number five, challenge to people. To hunger for the Holy Spirit. To pay the price to be filled with the Holy Spirit. So, I hope you learned this. Now, you can use different outlines. But it's good that to let people know, without certain God's nature, how life is. And how beautiful is His nature. When we talk about it, we don't just say, oh, He is powerful. But we want to meditate and think about how His power can change people, then raise up the life totally.
Okay,
and then number four, what hinders them to have the infilling of the Holy Spirit? Okay, so you can, you know, use this method to preach. If you use other outlines, you can also let people know how it is without God's nature and how beautiful God's nature is. Don't just preach about what people should do. But describe how beautiful God is. How wonderful is God's nature? So people like God's nature. Okay. God bless you. Hallelujah. Yeah. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Now we close with the prayer. Stand up. Oh Lord, come, Lord Jesus. Welcome, Jesus, to change our lives. We need you, Jesus. We are all weak. We need Jesus. Please forgive our sins. Wash us clean with the blood of Jesus. That we believe in your love and your power. God is almighty. God can change our lives. Lord Jesus, help us to dedicate our life to you. We want to follow God. We want to love God. And to be filled with the Holy Spirit. That we are changed by you. That our life will go higher and higher. Lord, give us that motivation. Use our life mightily. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We need you. We want you. We want to follow you. Please use our life. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name we pray.